إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره نؤمن به ونتوكل عليه نشكره ولا نكفره ونخلع ونترك من يفجره اللهم إياك نعبد ولك نصلي ونسجد وإليك نسعى ونحفد نرجو رحمتك ونخشى عذابك إن عذابك الجد بالكفار ملحق اللهم اهدنا فيمن هديت وتولنا فيمن توليت وعافنا فيمن عافيت واصرف عنا وقنا برحمتك شر ما قضيت إنك تقضي بالحق ولا يقضى عليك إنه لا يعز من عاديت ولا يذل من واليت تباركت ربنا وتعاليت نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله هو الأول والآخر والظاهر والباطن وهو بكل شيء عليم يعلم دبيب النملة السوداء على الصخرة الصماء في الليلة الظلماء ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله أرسله ربه على حين فترة من الرسل ليكون للعالمين نذيرًا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا فهدى به بعد الضلالة وأغنى به بعد الفقر ورفع به بعد الخسة وأعز به بعد الذلة وأقام به الملة العوجاء بأن قال الناس لا إله إلا الله فصلاة وسلاما دائمين متلازمين عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله ما تعاقب الليل والنهار وما ذكر الذاكرون الأبرار يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد My brothers and sisters Special greeting from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. تحية من عند الله مباركة طيبة. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وابتغوا إليه الوسيلة. O people who believe, fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and find a way to please Him. وابتغوا إليه الوسيلة. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala repeated the same meaning when you are making your supplications, when you are making your appeal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, try to find a way to use it before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a part of your appeal, part of your supplication. أولئك يدعون يبتغون إلى ربهم الوسيلة. يدعون ويبتغون, trying to find a way to please Allah سبحانه وتعالى, to make their دعاء, to make their عبادة, to make their supplications more acceptable, more appealing before Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And one of the ways people, they come and make dua right and left, and they forget about what you need to do before dua, what you need to do before you are making your ibadah. You have to find a way or ways to make a strong connection between you and the acceptance, strong connections between you and the approval for your good deeds. We are not machines doing things automatically. We are doing things without thinking. We have a mutual relation in our religion that you do things, you believe in it, and you are trying hard to make it acceptable. You are trying hard to make it acceptable by trying to find way of acceptance. We call this wasila, wasila. One of the great wasail, one of the great ways, the benefit of it is not limited to this, to the relation between you and Allah, but also spreading a strong connection between you and the people around you, extending your hand to help. Standing your hand to help, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in reality will not get any benefit from any sadaqah you provide, any help you provide. You are not helping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are not putting more bricks in His kingdom. And if you did not do it, you are not destroying anything from Him, from His kingdom and power. But actually Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it this way. He gave you to give the others to reward you. And He could give the others directly without passing by you. But in this case, you will not get any benefit. We have to look at it as we are a way of help. We are for the others wasila. And we can use this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help, as a way to please Him. This is very important, and we have to understand this concept. I'm making this introduction because we started this tradition to help some of our brothers who are described, according to the United Nations, the most oppressed ethnicity in this world. The most oppressed ethnic. I didn't understand this statement until I went and I saw them there. When I went to their camps, and we say word camps, we expect that you are talking about something. No, the description of it has nothing to do with camps at all. Just a group of people coming randomly in a jungle. They cut off some of the trees and most of the other trees still surrounding. And they already came and they are living there. We are not talking about 100 people making camp or going for picnic. We are talking about over 1 million. And you can imagine, those, they were kicked out. Some of them were killed. Some of them were taken to be slaves working for the Buddhists in Myanmar, and some of them still in the prisons over there, and most of them ran away from their lands. One day these people had life. Actually, the old days, a few centuries back, they had their own emirate. They had their own ruler. They were ruling their land, Arakan Kingdom. It's very famous when you study it in the history. And over sudden, because of what's going on in the Muslim world, there is no one to stand up for their rights, and there is no one to defend. Even countries, they are closing their borders. They are not welcoming them. Under one hope, these rulers that we have, these thieves, they have one thing, they don't want to hear about this. Not only Muslim rulers worldwide. The only country accepted them, Bangladesh. They came to the south of Bangladesh. Even Bangladesh did not open the doors to for them to live in the country. They allowed them just to live by the borders. Why? Because Bangladesh itself is very poor. 160 million and more than half of the country under the poverty line. And to be honest with you, when I visited this area, I didn't see much distinction between Bengali villages and the camp itself. It's meant to be this way, but the problem when you go there, this is not livable environment even for animals. You cannot concentrate 1 million animal in one place, one small place. Can you imagine how can you run the logistics? Having a clean water, forget about it. Just pumping water from the ground, whatever it is. There is no sewer system. There is no sewer system at all. Some people living uphill, some people living downhill, and those who are using the water from uphill coming down to the small bamboo houses down the hill. And down the hill you will see big lakes full of dirt, full of insects, all of the types. Mosquitoes, everything, you find it over there. And the most hurting part, when you see many of children running right and left. One of the first questions I asked my guide over there, how these kids know their bamboo houses? Out of thousands, how they can recognize this is their place from the other people's places? Everything looks the same over there. And when you go there, not even a Google map can help you. You need someone from the local to take you in, to take you out. Otherwise, you will keep moving in these zigzags. With all of this, as I mentioned before in my speech when I came back, the first thing they thought about to build it in each area, in each quarter side of the camp, the first thing they thought about it to build it, the masjid and the Quran school. Can you imagine this? They didn't forget about their religion, which is the only cause that they were kicked out of them from their houses. If they decided to be Buddhist, they will stay. Or even if they quit practicing their religion, they had a big mosques over there, they had Islamic institutions, they have a system of education. Even if they were not recognized as a citizen, they had their own one. And because of this, they were moved out, they were kicked out, they were killed. Otherwise, they will stay like any other ethnic living in this area. From our side, at least we have to remember these people. Now, I know the crisis is seizing all of the financial help and making us to live in fears. Some of us, they are living in difficulties. But compared to their situation, we are living in very luxurious life. And this is our role, to use what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is providing us to help these people who are completely forgotten. No one remembers them. Before, there was a huge short of supplies. Before COVID, a huge short of supplies. Can you imagine the situation now? Who can travel? Who can go there? Who can help? And this is the time to remember. Sayyiduna Uwais Al-Qarani, one of the great followers, he used to do a tradition and make a dua. We need to think about this dua. He was thinking about the needs of everyone. And he felt bad about himself that he will sleep at night and there is someone is not covered, somewhere hungry. And because of this, every night he takes everything in his house and distributes it. Whatever is left from food, whatever is left from clothes, he gives it out every night. Then he stands up and says this dua, Allahumma man mata ju'an fala tu'akhidhni bih. وَمَنْ مَاتَ عُرْيَانًا فَلَا تُؤَخِذْنِ بَهِ. Oh Allah, if someone died because of hunger, don't make me responsible for this. Because already I did my part. I give up all of what I have. Maybe you will not be able to save everyone. And this is why he thought about it from this perspective. And if someone died and he was naked, he doesn't have what is needed to cover himself. Oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't make me responsible. Don't make me responsible for this. This is the time of sadaqah. If you are asking me, I will tell you this is the best time to provide sadaqah. The Prophet, peace be upon him, was asked about what is the best time to give sadaqah. He said, the best time you give sadaqah, not when you have a lot. When you are wealthy and full. He said, when you are healthy and have little. Why when you are healthy and you have little? Because when you are healthy, you think that you will live more. And when you think that you are going to live more, you need to plan for the future. And you need to save money and you think about buying this or that. This is different from the case that if you are sick. If you are sick, you will be weak and you will not think about the future that much. But when you are have the thinking, this is the best time to give out. And you have little. وَأَنْتَ صَحِيحٌ شَحِيحٌ. You are facing or you are fearing the poverty. This is the time to give. Why? Because you are treating yourself. You are not giving from what is extra you have. You are giving from what you have, not the extra. And this a great sacrifice. This is a great sacrifice. This is the best way to give sadaqah now. We have fears. Yes, we have fears. We don't trust tomorrow. We don't trust tomorrow what's going to happen tomorrow. But in the same way, there is many people dying right and left. And these people are asked. They will not be forgiven because of COVID. They will be asked, what did they do in their life? The death is moving around. And this also the time to make something as a wasila. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu taqu Allah wa abtagu ilayhi al wasila. I'm extending an appeal to all of us to remember our brothers and sisters in Rohingya area. And we have a tradition, and the best practice you can do in your life, keeping your good traditions. خَيْرُ الْأَعْوَامِ أَعْمَالِ أَدْوَامُهَا. وَإِنْ قَلْ. Keep your good traditions, even if it's little by little. One of these traditions to make a special fundraising, annual fundraising for them. We couldn't make it in Ramadan because we didn't come together, but this is the time. I ask every single one of us today, every single one, no exceptions. I will not make an exception for anyone, wealthy or poor. You have good style of life or you are in need, because this might be one of the last actions you do. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save all of us, but might be, and make it as a wasila for your supplications to be accepted, for your good deeds to be approved. Whatever you can give, if each one of us at least give 100 today, we will be able to collect $15,000 to $20,000 to give it just to fill a small gap for the huge need over there. So please take this opportunity and don't leave. All of the collections of today will not be directed to the masjid, will be directed to this cause. Before you leave, stop by Brother Izhar or downstairs and put something in the box. If you don't have it, bring it to me later on. Even if you have a check or credit or any way you would like to use it, get in touch with us. Inshallah, we'll help you to do your donation. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of our sins. قل الحمد لله وكفى وسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى الله خير أما يشركون. Today inshallah is Friday and we are in the 9th of Ashura. Tomorrow is the 10th of Ashura, which is highly recommended for people to fast. If you did fast the 10th by itself, that's fine. If you would like to add one day before or one day after, that's fine. The Prophet, peace be upon him, did celebrate the 10th of Muharram, the 10th of Muharram, as appreciation, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for saving Musa ibn Imran in this day from the Pharaohs. With this, we can add Nurun ala Nur. Just make your donation as an appeal for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept your deeds in the Ashura. In Ashura. For make your donation with the intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept your deeds in the 10th of Ashura. And what is the reward of accepting your deeds in Ashura? Forgiving all of your sins, minor sins for the previous year. Forgiving all of your minor sins for the previous year. Finally, just I would like to bring up to your attention one quick announcement. We realize that most of the people attending the first Jum'ah, and we have to remind you that we have two Friday prayers. And if we spread ourselves equally in between two Jum'ahs, we will not have what we are facing downstairs, that people praying in front of the bathrooms, people praying outside in the parking lot. If some of our brothers and sisters voluntarily decided to come to the second Jum'ah, there is no difference between first one or second one. You will have the same reward. Our second Jum'ah will be first Jum'ah for you. There is no difference in the reward to come for the first or to come for the second, but it will make our job much easier, if some people decided to come for the second Jum'ah. At least we need one third of the attendance of the first Jum'ah to give up this time and to come for the second Jum'ah. This will make it easy for all of us. Say that and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive all of our sins, to accept all of our good deeds. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَإِسْرَافَنَا فِي أَمْرِنَا ثَبِّتْ أَقْدَامَنَا وَانْصُرْنَا عَلَى الْقَوْمِ الْكَافِرِينَ. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها زكيها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها مولاها. اللهم ارحمنا فإنك بنا راحم ولا تعذبنا فأنت علينا قادر. والطف بنا مولانا فيما جرت به المقادير برحمتك وفضلك ومنك وجودك وبركة حضرة النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام. وأقم الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله. يا رسول الله يا فقامت الصلاة قامت الصلاة. الله أكبر الله لا إله إلا الله.
الله أكبر. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين وأدخل الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها بإذن ربهم تحيتهم فيها سلام ألم تر كيف ضرب الله مثلا كلمة طيبة كشجرة طيبة أصلها ثابت وفرعها في السماء تؤتي أكلها كل حين بإذن ربها ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس لعلهم يتذكرون الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين ألم تر كيف ضرب الله مثلا كلمة طيبة كشجرة
طيبة أصلها ثابت وفرعها في السماء تؤتي أكلها كل حين بإذن ربها ويضرب الله الأمثال للناس لعلهم يتذكرون ومثل كلمة خبيثة كشجرة خبيثة اجتثت من فوق الأرض اجتثت من فوق الأرض ما لها من قرار يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ويضل الله الظالمين ويفعل الله ما يشاء يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالحياة الدنيا يثبت الله الذين آمنوا بالقول الثابت في الحياة الدنيا في الحياة الدنيا وفي الآخرة ويضل الله الظالمين ويفعل الله ما يشاء
الله سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
إن شاء الله we have a request for دعاء a cousin of what's your name brother Suhail a cousin of our brother Suhail over there he passed away in Pakistan he was a medical doctor and passed of COVID We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, passed away of COVID. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant him Jannah and accept him among the righteous. Allahumma afihi wa afu anhu. Allahumma akrim nuzulah. Allahumma ahsin mudkhalah. Allahumma jazihi bil ihsani ahsanan wa bil sayyi'ati afwan wa ghufran. Allahumma adilu daran khayra min darih wa ahlan khayra min ahlih wa ja'al mathwana wa mathwana fi al-dawsa al-a'la. Wa ahshurna wa iyahu fi zumratin nabiyyina wa s-siddiqina wa shuhada'i wa s-salihin wa hasuna ulaika rafiq. Please don't forget to donate for this great cause that we talked about in your way out. Give your donation, not the brown boxes. Give it in the white boxes with Brother Ishar and Brother downstairs.